Welcome to Beyond the Press channel. Today I'm going to do short tire video. Here is my truck or our company's truck behind me. And it has street tires. And they are quite worn out. So I have to change these soon. And on the off-road these are completely useless. And also the winter is coming and it's like usually like 2 months like maybe winter and then like 3 months winter and 2 months maybe winter. So it would be good to have like intermediate tires. And since I'm also driving some off-road things, I'm going to put these there. Ta-da! Yep, so there was the tires, and how about the rims? I have those here. These are 17 inch, so 1 inch larger than the original. And same size than on the Wildtrak model. These are like not over the top, but like slightly redneck. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, I think those are pretty cool. Yep, and the tires don't fit under the like bed cover, so I put them like this. I think they look kind of cool there, and I think I'm going to like drive the car to my yard, and then ask Anni out and get her reaction to our new tires. I want your opinion about the tires.
Okay.
They are on the bed of the truck. Wait. I have to go like first so I can film you. Yeah?
Vittua! Miksi nää on noin iso? They are huge.
Yeah, they are quite large, I would say. They didn't fit under the press thing, so I had to put them like that.
I think they don't fit under the car.
Yeah, but the car goes up when you put them there, so they make like more room. Yeah, I think we are going to put them like tomorrow under there or something. Yep, and as you can see, I didn't manage to sell this here, but I think I can sell this on the next summer or spring.
Please buy this.
Yeah, please buy. Very good car.
Very good, very nice.
Yeah, and the reason we are driving with this is the fact that I decided also to put some lights and stuff to the truck, and I'm so busy and I really hate electric work. I don't want to like any wiring and installing like switches. I don't like that. So I ordered the job from a local like car workshop, and it should be now ready. So we are going to pick it up, and then you also see the tires under the truck. I forgot to film the installing part, but it was really poor weather. It was raining and it was like, it's pretty boring to swap tires. So nothing to see there, so we are going to skip straight to end result.
Yay! So exciting! Okay.
Yep, so here we are. And
Honda Service.
Yeah. Is it Honda also?
No, I mean Ford Service.
Yeah, this is not like official dealership, but Timo has always service.
Hey, is there?
Ah, looks pretty nice.
Cool.
This here. Joo, vähän nää on hyvä. Yep, so we have mud flaps on the front because of the tires. Then big ass lights and this you can hit like everything. Yep, so new round around the truck. And first we have the extra lights. Those are handy in Finland. Here is always dark.
Yeah, as you can see.
Yeah, you will see when we go around the car that most of this is because it's dark.
Yeah.
And then we have like this steel thing. Anni would like to have like larger.
Yeah, this is too small. I think it would be much larger.
Yeah, so you could run like over small animals and pedestrians.
Yeah.
Yeah, but maybe we can build some spikes there to make it more dangerous. And then what else? Then the mud flaps. Pretty good because tires are pretty large. I might also buy things here like flares, like plastic things that you can glue there. I'm not sure is it street legal because I think the tire comes slightly out from the car, or maybe not. Probably not. Yeah, and then we have shitload of lights there. So these are for like loading, and these are like working here and checking that I'm not like running over anything. And then
this is the most important part here.
Yeah, it's really important because it's really hard to adjust your trailer when you are not seeing shit. But now we can see pretty well.
Because it's camera.
And that's actually wireless, and the picture will appear in our navigator. I think we have to try that out.
Yeah.
So when the car is on and I switch to reverse, it should appear there instead of the navigator. Ta-da!
Yeah.
And you can see the towing thing there. So that's
super cool.
That's really great.
Yeah.
Awesome. And back to drive and it goes to navigator. And that's good because I was a bit annoyed with my old van because we had navigator here and camera here. Two screens.
Yeah.
And when you are reversing, you usually know where you are going, so you don't need this while doing that. So I think this is good setup.
Yep. Are you happy now?
Yeah, I think this is really good. Yep, and one thing that I kind of wanted, but it was so expensive to buy and install that I didn't get it, was the winch on the front. But I did some research and you can buy like with couple hundred euros like big like hand winch that is capable of pulling like 3 or 4 tons. And here is actually, I checked, there is points that is like good for recover. So if I just buy that hand winch, I can take it with me if I know that we are going to go in like challenging place, and if we get stuck I can not only winch forward but also backwards. So I think that's like good budget solution because the electric winch on the front, it would be like 3000 euros with the installing kit and some work to put it there. So I think that's too much. And if we get stuck, it's probably in the countryside place. And we have huge tractor there, so we can always get that. Yeah, but that is all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day.